behalf of the University of Northwest Ohio, we welcome you here to the garage for today's coaching announcement. I am the Sports Information Director, Challen Stewart, here at UNOH. Again, we welcome all of you into the garage here on the campus of the University of Northwestern Ohio. I'll keep it brief. I'm going to hand it off here to our Athletic Director, Chris Adams, to make our announcement for our new women's basketball coach. Chris?
Thank you, Joe. I'm very excited today to have this opportunity to announce Andre Smith as our new head women's basketball coach at University of Northwestern Ohio. It's a very unique hire for me personally because Andre Smith and I have a lot in common. And that may be bad for him, but we have a lot in common. He did a tremendous job at Lord starting that program and from scratch, a little bit like we were doing here back in 2007 and 2008 and 2009. He was a little bit later than that, and we had a lot of conversation at starting the programs from scratch and going into the league, and we both entered the WAC together, and a lot of phone calls between the two of us back in those days. And by the way, he's an excellent basketball coach, and he was a foe, and our games were heated, and we were not sending each other Christmas cards from 2010 to 2016, that's for sure. And but here, as things go and you get older and you step off the court a little bit, we maintained a very good friendship as we both took off and I went into the administrative route and he took a couple other different coaching opportunities after leaving Lords. But we never lost our friendship, we never lost the respect for each other. And what happened during the interview process is everything I thought and believed in him as a man came to fruition, and the rest of the committee agreed with me, and therefore I'm very proud to announce Andre Smith to be our coach, because he's a man of integrity, he's got a great past, and we can use, we need his experience as we move forward with this program. So Andre, without further ado, the microphone is yours.
Thank you, Chris. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. First of all, I'd like to just say a special thanks to President Jarvis and obviously Chris as the athletic director. Also giving a special thanks to the search committee for giving me this opportunity. Like Chris said, our relationship and friendship goes back for some time now on and off the court. And so it's always an honor to stay connected. A lot of times you have battles with coaches and athletic directors and you see different things different ways, but throughout the process we stayed in contact, and this opportunity came about. You know, and a lot of people always ask, well, coach, you know, you haven't coached women in over 15 years or so, and the thing that I've talked about during my interview process and why people ask that I take this position is that the X's and O's doesn't change, the ingredients to be successful doesn't change, the hard work, the commitment, the dedication at any level. You know, previously before taking this position, you know, I was a professional scout at two different professional organizations, and it's the same thing. You know, I continue to carry that down as a former Division I coach as well. So it's, again, it's an opportunity for me to immerse myself into the community. I had an opportunity over the last 2 days to meet the team, talk to the team, talk about our vision, our goals, what it takes to be successful. And when I talk about what it takes to be successful, we're not talking about the X's and O's, we're talking about what it takes successful in life. And I think that's where it starts at. And I tell everyone, my main goal here is to make sure these young ladies be successful in life. Every job, every college, collegiate job that I've taken, that is my main focus, to make sure those young men or young women be successful in the classroom, in the community, and go on to be successful citizens. I think athletics is just a catapult to making sure to give those intangibles that you need in order to be successful, is the hard work, the teamwork, and those things like that. So, you know, the young ladies were upbeat. We had a great conversation. We had a great couple meetings. We had our first couple workouts the last 2 days. This is very exciting. We're looking forward to it. I know it's going to be a different style than what maybe they're used to, and Chris can attest to that. I'm more of the defensive-minded, grinded type of coach. So it may not be so exciting as to what today's game is the high scoring and a lot of threes, but I think the ultimate goal is to make sure we have more points than the opponent have. So, you know, I'm up for the challenge. Like I said, And one of the reasons why I was interested in this job is because I know you can win here. Chris has proven that when we were on the men's side. I know the success here and the administration. I think in order to take jobs, one of the first things you have to do is to look at the administration. Does the administration support the vision, and not just the athletic vision, but the academic and the holistic obscope of when you see the whole part of the program? I've been in programs where we didn't have that support. We maybe had the support from the athletic standpoint, but not the holistic approach to making sure the young man or the young woman is being successful. And that is in place here. I know you can win here. Chris has proven it. He knows what it takes to win. The resources are here. The foundation is here. It's about getting the right people in the right places. It's making sure that the young ladies believe. It's changing the mind frame. The ladies kept asking me, what is your vision? And one thing I've always tell them is winning is an attitude. You have to have a winner's attitude. And sometimes people want to win, but they don't want to put the work in to be successful. So that's one of the big things that we are looking to change. Again, I want to just, again, to thank President Jarvis. I want to thank Chris Adams. I want to thank everyone, the search committee, for giving me this opportunity, to get back into the collegiate realm of it and to be around the students. And that's why it's called a student athlete, to make sure they are successful, making sure we give them the tools and everything what it needs to be successful when the ball stops bouncing.
Andre Smith has been named the new head basketball coach of the women's program here at the University of Northwestern Ohio. And coach, first off, congratulations. Just talk about the process of getting to meet with your girls and how has that gone so far?
Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. It's going well. Over the last 3 or 4 days, I had the opportunity to meet with each girl individually. We met as a team twice and just talked about the vision of the program. Expectations, what we're looking to try to achieve, but more importantly, we talked about how are we going to achieve that. A lot of times people or a lot of times the girls talk about being successful and they're talking about winning, but we have to have a plan. How are we going to get there? So our first 3 or 4 days are talking about how are we going to get there. We all want to win, we all want to be successful, but how are we going to get there?
Talk about your philosophy as a coach. You're no stranger to UNOH,
right?
Having been the men's coach at Lourdes from 2009 to 2015. You also served as athletic director for a time as well. You've got a familiarity with Coach Adams. Was that something that appealed to you in the whole process of potentially coming to Lima and being the coach here?
Well, yeah, that, obviously I wouldn't, you know, I have to be honest, that was probably one of the main reasons. Our relationship with Chris that we talked about, you know, as we did our battles when I was the men's coach. But, you know, when I look at situations and job opportunities, one of the things we do look at is administration. Who are you going to work for? Do they understand athletics? And being Chris, being a former coach here, I knew he knows what it takes to be successful because he had success. And the infrastructure and the support is here to be successful.
Talk about, from a coaching perspective, your philosophy. Are you a guy that wants to run, get up and down the floor, go as fast as possible with what you have with your personnel? Obviously, you start defense, and you have a defensive background with your time at Lourdes, too, that you brought up in the initial press conference, too.
Yeah, if you talk to any of my former players, they're going to tell you 95% of our practice will be defense. 95% of our game situations will be defense. So it is going to be a unique style. Promote the up-tempo, a lot of shooting threes. I think we control what we control as defense. So you'll see a smart, high-intense defensive team, a very disciplined team. Every player that I've ever coached will tell you about, coach is very, very disciplined. I believe discipline can not only win you games, but keep you in games. So it is going to be a different style. They're going to have to commit to the defensive end. And that's the success that I had. You know, when I was at Lourdes, we led the country 4 years in a row for team defense. And I pride our program on defense.
Defense wins championships, too.
Exactly, exactly.
Coach, I know one of the things that when you look at this women's program, you're the third head coach, whether it be an interim coach or actual physical head coach in the last 6 months. How important is it for you to bring some stability to the program?
I think it's very important. The young ladies went through a lot this year, and I think we all went through a lot with the pandemic and everything, and then we had the coaching change and, you know, Chris stepping in for, unfortunately, with the current assistant, Jill, was out. So stability is important. Anything in life, I think in order to be successful, you want to know there's some stability there, knowing that the coach is going to be here, knowing the coaching staff is going to be here. And I think it does is one of the very key points to being successful. So my plan is to be here. My plan is to build our program. Our plan is to make sure our kids are successful on and off the court in the community and building that fan base.
You mentioned staff. You mentioned players and stuff like that. Do you have an idea as far as staff yet? You're going to try to retain Coach Segura? You're going to, along the flip side, what's a Coach Andre Smith player? But what are you looking for? You looking to go to Lido? You looking to stay, you know, local? You do have a lot of ties in that area, as mm-hmm. we said. You know, try to maybe blanket a 2 to 3 hour radius. You're going to maybe try to go the JUCO route and just try to find the best fit regardless.
I think the best fit. Obviously, you know, I've had some interviews with some candidates, and obviously, you know, feel strongly with Jill being a having her personality. She's been here, she knows the program, she knows the girls is also a positive. But I think sometimes when you're looking at jump starting, you have to look at the whole picture. You got to look at it, not just the best candidate. Number one, who can you get? And number one, it's about, you know, building relationships and recruiting. So we have to get players in here. We have to get staff in here that understands our philosophy, staff in here that understands what we're trying to do.
Coach, congratulations. Welcome to Lima. We're glad to have you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Coach Andre Smith, the new women's basketball coach here at the University of Northwestern Ohio.